Hi, my name is Nona Tobin, and I am sending this message to the Nevada Commission on Judicial Discipline. And I received notice that the complaint that I filed on the 26th, and today's the 28th of January 2021, was rejected because it needs to be mailed in with an original signature. I'll mail this to you, but it really doesn't work if you don't have live hyperlinks, because there are so many documents. And so I am attaching to this email a 100-page or so complaint that has links to the documents that are evidence of what I'm complaining about. The complaint is against Judge Joanna Kishner, who is Department 31 in the 8th Judicial District Court in Las Vegas. And I am complaining about her ex parte communication with opposing counsel and with her failure to properly adjudicate any of the claims in the consolidated cases that were under her jurisdiction, and for her acting outside of her jurisdiction by allowing plaintiffs to prevail without providing any evidence whatsoever, and for her proceeding when I was the only party who was compliant with NRS 38310, and that's the requirement that any case involving the interpretation of HOA, CCNRs, and governing documents requires mediation. And no party, except for me, in both of my capacities as a trustee and as an individual, completed mediation. So that's my issue. The other issue is that because of this ex parte hearing where Judge Kishner listened to these two counsels that she met with after I was served notice that this hearing was continued, she met with them, and they decided among themselves that I had never been a party, even though I had been filing into these consolidated cases since July 29th, 2016. And I filed all of the pleadings, and I filed all of everything. And they just decided that it was never in the record. Well, the record is explicitly clear. And so what I want the commission to look at are these documents, which are pretty clear on their face, that show that this meeting occurred, they made these decisions that were substantive issues of the case, and they affected the outcome of the trial. And at the trial, there was no documentary evidence allowed, and I'm the only party that had any documentary evidence that was verified and corroborated and undisputed. Judge Kishner never ruled on the very fundamental issues of standing of the other parties, the parties that she met with ex parte. And so, anyway, the whole case became a huge mess, and it was hugely expensive. I was forced to file another complaint in a different district court, and now that judge has refused to listen to the case on the grounds that of claims preclusion, that I was trying to get a second bite of the apple, saying that I was unable, my case had already been adjudicated, which it had not. All these documents that you will see is that in the first case under Judge Kishner, there was no adjudication of anybody's claims. And I was explicitly removed as a party, like practically on the day of the trial, when I was allowed to testify at the trial as a trustee. I was not allowed to have any documents. And it was a grossly unfair sanction based on alleged attorney misconduct, which was only opposing counsel Joseph Hong's misconduct. And yet I was the one that was punished. And then going to try and resolve this in a second district court case, I was prevented from having any of my claims heard because the opposing counsels, again, Joseph Hong, main perpetrator, and now added in others, they just convinced the judge that the case had already been heard and that it needed to be just handled on the appeal. Well, I have four appeals now in front of the Supreme Court that are going to mediation on February 2nd or 5th. And it's just impossible to resolve this, no matter how much money and how many attorneys and how many hours I throw at it. It is impossible to get a judge to look at the evidence, because the only evidence that is in the record and the only evidence that is verified all supports me. And I have been, now it's going on to 5 years, dealing with this, and what I want is a fair adjudication of my claims. I want these attorneys who are lying on the record, who are putting in false claims into their filings, into court, and are recording falsified affidavits and just clouding the title and getting away with it because it is not being adjudicated. And I will send you in, as you requested, this in a hard copy if you need that to prove that I'm really making this complaint. But I really think you ought to look at this as a video of me, the real person. I am making this complaint. I will say this, everything I say under oath. And I appreciate your consideration of this matter promptly. Thank you.